a couple of cookies in my hand, you know, strip the hot dog. And what we're going to do initially is just get her used to me holding this collar, touching her head. You know, a lot of dogs don't like this kind of stuff. And, you know, the boxer showed us that she doesn't like your hands all over her every day yesterday. So I'm just going to put my hands in the collar, rub on her ear and feet. This is all we're going to do to start with, okay? So this is pretty much it. I'm just going to say take it and let her have it. She's going to sit here and eat her feet. This is the easiest thing. Step one. Sit here and love me touching your ear, okay? All right? I don't want, when I reach for my dog, to correct it for retrieving. The last thing I really want from her is for her to go, ooh, I don't like it. Because then I have to bring the attitude back up. And I don't want to do that. So I'm just starting the cookie, letting her. It's basically like a free-for-all. She just gets to sit here and love on eating cookies, okay? As we get a little more into this, I'm gonna start putting my command, take it, which is the command that I'm gonna use the dumbbell, to the cookies. I'm just gonna hold the cookie up here and say, take it. And I want her to start jumping up. So those of you with lower drive dogs, the jump up is important, and it's gonna be the hard part of this piece.
Take.
So I'm gonna hold it up and take it. And she jumps up. I'm not pinching, I'm just holding her ear right now. You know? There's no pinching going on. All right, so this is step one. Hold the ear, hold the collar, and tell them to jump up. Okay? And you tell her. She's like, I'll get it. All right? Step two is going to be, I'm going to start adding some pressure to the collar. So I'm going to hold the cookie, and I'm going to pop up as I say the word take. So I'm going to take it. Pop up with the collar. Now, they bite your fingers off like she's biting mine, and you bleed a little bit, you'll be fine. So again, we just show that we're holding the ear, we're not putting pressure yet. She has not failed to retrieve, so I'm not putting pressure on the dog. I'm letting her, here's the cookie. Cookie, ear, words are take it, and I pop up. Good girl, love it. Okay, very clear, very simple. Step number two. So you'll do each one of these steps as the dogs are good at it. You know, I mean, you just build. So then, I'm gonna say, okay, ready? Ready? Take it. She jumps up and I get the cookie. Now one day, and I wait for that day to happen, one day she's going to say, you know, not today, Dad. And the reason I wait is because I never want to stifle her enthusiasm for this, but I also know that one day is going to happen. If you have a dog that's really crazy about food or really high drive, one day you may have to make it happen. Okay, so sometimes I just do this and take it, but she doesn't. Okay, like I just did. I changed my tone to make her not jump up for it so that I can show you. That's going to quit working because as I demo her a lot in seminars, she's going to start to realize, look, anytime he says, I should jump up. So I said it already. She didn't take it. So I'm going to hold the cookie here. I'm going to hold the cookie here, apply pressure, pop up, and let her take it. Okay? That's an ear. Yes, I use the flats of my fingers on the tip of her ear. I'm not going down in the ear canal. Now look, if I had to add pressure to a dog, I'd probably need to back up a few steps. Now, again, right now, we're trying to teach it motivational. We're trying not to make this the big, ugly ear pinch that you've seen before, where the dog's screaming and flailing on its back and doing stupid stuff. I don't want that in my dog. And with this dog, who's ridiculously soft, it would not be a good combination. So again, I would say take it. She doesn't take it. I'm going to hold the cookie, apply the pressure, pop the collar, boom. Okay? I want to teach her how to avoid me pinching her ear. That's what I'm teaching her. Okay? So as I do this, show the cookie, tell her to take it. She jumps and she says, don't pinch my ear anymore. I've been waiting for this, okay? If I don't get to this point, then we have a problem, okay? So this part is just as important as putting the dumbbell to it. So don't skip this step. Do not skip this step. So the next part that I do is I put the cookie now
on the dum-dum. So we're going to hold the cookie here. We're going to hold the ear, hold the collar, show the cookie, get it. Boom. I say take it. I'm using get it just so I can hopefully throw her off. So I can show you the brush. So again, we now are putting the cookie on the bell of the dumbbell. Show the cookie, hold the collar, here's the ear, get it. She jumps up and gets it. So I'll do this for a little while until she fails it. She'll fail it again at some point, or I'll make her fail it by swirling around her head. And I'll swirl it around her head and I'll say, up, take it. She doesn't do anything. I'm going to hold the collar, hold the ear, apply pressure, and she's going to jump the cookie. She's learned, he will stop pressing on my ear when I jump to this cookie. Now, let me explain something. You have to let go. Okay? You have to let the ear go. So when I'm holding the collar, I'm holding the ear, I'm holding the cookie and the dumbbell, the minute she jumps for it, I just let go of the dumbbell. I don't wait because I know she's going for it because I built it all immediately. So I do that part. That's the next step. Okay? The third step in all of this would be going to just the dumbbell, okay? So I would hold the ear, hold the collar, hold the dumbbell. And I've already told her to jump up to the dumbbell with the cookie. So now I'm gonna say, ready, take it. She doesn't take it. I'm gonna apply pressure, she's gonna put it in the dumbbell. If this doesn't happen, you go back to step four. All dogs learn this differently. It took her about 3 days for me to get through the force retreat. Once I got to the fifth stage, I always work up. So I want to say, get it. She doesn't get it. I'm going to apply pressure, take it. She's like, get it, it's not my word. Ready? Apply pressure, take it. I apply pressure, pop the collar, and she doesn't go. I'm just going to hold. Hold pressure. Take it. Good. She had to say, I'm not going to. Okay, fine. I'm going to hold pressure. I'm not getting harder. I'm holding pressure. Okay? So, you know, they don't love this part of it, but it's not horrible. Take it. She comes up to it. Okay? No problem. No ear pinch that time. So if they say, no, I don't want it, you put the pressure on and you hold the pressure until she decides to make a decision. The dog has to make a decision. Obedience must be decisive. So, those are the first three steps of the force retreat. It's very, very simple. It's not difficult. But, just because it's not difficult, doesn't mean that it's the most fun you've ever had. But, I find it necessary. When I see the dogs in the obedience ring that don't understand a specific correction, and when I mean specific correction for a failure to retrieve, we see a lot of problems. Yes, he shuts up. Those are the three steps that I want.